Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Amen. Now, the Lord has spoken with me. The Lord Jehovah Elohim, Jehovah Oseno, Jehovah Adonai, Jehovah Sabaoth, Jehovah Rohi, Jehovah El Olam El Yon. He has spoken with me today about what is coming to South Africa. I have seen South Africa. The Lord has spoken with me about the nation of South Africa. And I see the judgment of the Lord coming towards South Africa. I see tension. The Lord took me there. And I could see up there a clash. A clash between, I think, Zulus and some people. There's going to be ethnic clashes in South Africa. I don't know whether it's going to be a form of xenophobia, but I see ethnic clashes. I hear Zulu. So there's a clash between different ethnic groups, and I see people hitting at each other, fighting each other. It's very violent when the Lord shows me up the hill, and then it spreads all the way down. The Lord takes me to South Africa, so I also run for my life. They're looking for a particular ethnic community. These are ethnic clashes in South Africa. And I run for my life as those people spread, the spread now of ethnic clashes in South Africa. And the Lord has spoken very clearly when I was in South Africa, in Durban, that the church in South Africa needs to mobilize a national repentance and prepare for the coming of the Messiah. The church in South Africa, the few pastors I talked to when I was there, I made it very clear that this message is not negotiable. It is about the coming of the Messiah. And it's a message of love that the Lord can ask us to return to righteousness, a threshold that must be scored for the kingdom of God. And so I see a very, very severe ethnic distress coming to South Africa. And I see people running and so forth. The Lord puts me there. I run for my life also. And so this is what the Lord is saying at this time, even as we sit on the verge of a major, major, major visitation in Nakuru, Kenya. The Messiah is coming, and this is the hour to celebrate righteousness and holiness. If there's any hour at which to abandon every other cause and just pursue holiness, it is this hour to teach it to your children in Mexico, in South Africa, and globally. Teach it to your wives, teach it to your husbands, teach it to your brothers, teach it to your church, teach it to the land. Because it will for sure be beneficial to focus and invest on righteousness and holiness at this hour in the history of the church. Remember, I have seen the coming of the Messiah. I have seen the Messiah come for a holy church, a glorious church. And the Bible speaks very clearly in Daniel chapter 12, verse 1 on, before he celebrates the taking up of their sleep in Christ Jesus, those for whom he prepared rooms in heaven. The Lord went to prepare rooms in heaven before they are taken. The Lord talks about this preamble of this introduction of great historic distress that will consume the nations, that does consume the nations. And he says, after that, then there is the taking up of the saints. When the distress now escalates beyond when the church has been taken up. May the Lord be blessed. Shalom.